This conference will now be recorded. This conference will now be recorded.
Yeah, is it fine now?
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Right. So let's see. Today we'll start with what structures. Okay. So we have this structures concept in what C language also. So what is basically a structure? A structure is nothing but a user defined data type. So far we have seen how to work with the standard data types, like we have seen integer, character, okay, string, okay, all those comes under what standard data types, means which are provided by what SAP itself. Okay, so we have something called as structures. We can call a structure as a user defined data type. Okay, structure is a user defined data type, which is a collection of what different types of fields. Okay, I repeat, a structure is a user defined data type, which is a collection of different types of fields. Okay, so if you take our C language, so when do we go for structures? Whenever you want to store some interrelated data, okay, in that cases we'll go for what structures. When I say interrelated data, suppose I want to store some employee data, like employee number, employee name, employee designation. So all this data is what interrelated data. So whenever you want to store this kind of data, okay, we'll go for what structures. Okay. So if you take our C language, how do you declare a structure in C language? We use a keyword called as struct. Suppose assume that I want a structure which stores the employee data. So it's a struct emp. Okay, this is in case of C language. Okay, and you'll declare some fields like this. Suppose I want to store employee number, employee name, employee or something float, employee salary. Okay, this is the way you create the structure in case of what C language. So my structure contains how many fields here? Three fields. One is integer, next character, next what float. Okay, so once a structure is created, okay, if you want to store the data in that structure, in this case of C language, if I say like this, this is invalid. Okay, this is invalid because I cannot directly access the structure fields. You need to create the variable for the structure. How do you create the variable for the structure? You will say struct structure name. Let me give the structure name as something emp, followed by what? Some variable name. So I'll give the variable name as something k. Understood? So you need to create a structure by using the struct keyword. Okay, and whatever we declare inside that structure, we call them as structure fields, right? So once you create a structure, memory will not be allocated. Memory will be allocated only when you create variable for a structure. I'm talking about C language. So if I directly try to store the data like this, it will give syntax error. So if you want to access the structure fields, we need to create what structure variable. After creating the variable, you will say structure variable dot, what is this field name, equal to something like this. Okay. So you have to say structure variable dot structure field followed by what, some data, whatever you want. This is the way you declare and access the structure fields in case of what C language. Okay. Now let us see how to create structures in what ABAP. Again, there are multiple syntaxes for declaring what structures. We'll discuss one after the other. So first, let me go for a basic syntax for declaring the structure. First of all, we need to decide when do we go for structures. Whenever you want to store interrelated data one after the other, we'll go for what structures. Okay. So let me show you how to create structures in C language in ABAP. One second, I'm connecting to the server. I'm having the connectivity issue. Just hold on, please. Okay, right. So I'll go to ABAP editor SC30H. Let me give the object name Z645 program 13. Create. Okay, so I'll just give some title, declaring structures and accessing what structure fields. Type of program as usual, executable program. I will save it in the local object. Done. Yeah. Okay. So what I want to declare a structure which contains what which has to store the employee data. So we need to analyze what fields you need to declare. I want to declare employee number, employee name, and employee designation. So I'll say data. Okay, so for declaring variables also we use what data keyword. Data, I'll use a chain operator, begin of structure name. You can give any name. Let me give a structure name as EMP, and as part of the structure declaration, I'll declare some fields like employee number type I. Okay, employee name of 20 type C. Then employee designation of 20 type C. Then I'll close the structure. End of what? EMP. Make clear? So I declared a structure which contains what? Three fields: employee number, employee name, and employee designation. Okay. So in case of C language, after creating the structure, we must create the variable for the structure. Then only memory will be allocated. But whereas in ABAP, the moment you declare the structure like this, memory will be allocated. How much memory is allocated means it depends on the structure field. So in this case, my structure has got three fields, so the memory allocation would be something like this. So all the fields are stored one after the other. This is one of the advantage of what structures. All the structure fields will be stored one after the other adjacently. Okay, so assume that this is employee number, employee name, and this is employee designation. Okay, employee number is what type? Integer. So already we know in ABAP, numeric data types are initialized to what? Zeros, and characters will be initialized to what? Space. And again, employee designation is also character. This also will be initialized to what? Space. Okay, done. So assume that the starting address location for the employee number field is 100. For example, internally you will have some address location. Assume that the address location is 100. So here, what is the data type of this employee number? Integer. So in ABAP, integer occupies 4 bytes. So 100 to 104 would be what? Employee number. 100 to 104 will be employee number. Then, okay, assume that this I'll give it as 15 something. Employee name of 15 type C. So again, from 104 to 119, sorry, 119 will be employee name, and employee designation I give character of 20. So 119 to 139 will be what? Employee designation. So overall, if you observe, for this structure, what is the structure name? EMP. Okay, what is the overall memory allocated? 39 bytes of memory will be allocated, and all the structure fields will be stored one after the other. So since they are stored one after the other, the accessing would be what? Faster. Understood? So instead of declaring them inside the structure, if I declare them as individual fields, I cannot guarantee that all the fields are stored one after the other. But if you declare them inside a structure, yes, all the fields will be stored one after the other, which will increase the accessing speed. Whenever we access, the accessing speed will be what? Faster. Okay, so this is how the memory is allocated for your structure. In this case, 39 bytes of memory are allocated. Done. Again, if you go back to C language, in order to access the structure fields, I must create what? Structure variable. And using that variable and dot operator, I have to access the structure field. But whereas here, this is my structure, it has got three fields. I can directly access the structure fields by using what? Structure name. So EMP, I cannot say dot here, because in ABAP, dot indicates what? End of the statement. So I have to use hyphen here. EMP, that is structure name hyphen. Okay, before this, before I access them, let me check what are the values inside this. As I told you, whenever a structure is created, memory will be allocated for the structure fields, and they get initialized to what? Default values depending on their data type. So let me try to display them. So right, I'll just give some message here. What? EMP structure, some message. Okay, then in the next line, I'll access the fields. How do we access the structure fields? Structure name hyphen structure field, EMP hyphen employee number, EMP hyphen employee name, and EMP hyphen what? Employee designation. So when I execute this, yes, what I got? I got 0 space, employee number is what? 0. Employee name is space, employee designation is again also what? Initialized what? Space. So these are the default values. Let me try to assign some data. EMPI for employee number is equal to 4. Then I'll say EMPI for employee name equal to, I'll say something, and EMPI for employee designation equal to something manager. So one more important point is, when do we go for structure? Is whenever you want to store a record kind of information, we'll go for what? Structure. So in this case, what happens? These default values, that is 0, space and space, will be overwritten with the initialized values. What are the initialized values? 4, this is Raju, and this is something what? Manager. Okay, I got 4 Raju and what? Manager. Let me try to print it. So at any point of time, a structure can accommodate only what? Single value. So I'm just reprinting it. Single record, I mean to say. So when I execute, I'll get the latest record. What is that? 4 Raju and what? Manager. At any point of time, a structure can accommodate only what? Single record, single set of values. So when I debug this, let me try to debug. This comes under what? Declaration. Variable declarations I cannot debug. I can debug only what? Executable statement. So after activating the program, let me try to debug from this 9th line. So I'll put the cursor here. I'll set the session breakpoint. Breakpoint has been set. When I say F8, okay, so this is my new debugger screen. This is new debugger screen. Okay, so Yeah, what I'll do is initially let me use the old debugger screen. So if you get the new debugger screen, how do we switch the old debugger screen in older versions? In the older versions, in the debugger menu only, we have an option called as switch to classic debugger. I can choose to switch to classic debugger, but here I don't have that option in the debugger menu. Somewhere in the go to menu, I'll choose navigate to, what is it? Switch to classic debugger. Okay, so I'm switching to the old debugger. Then I got the old debugger. So see here, structure is already created. So if you observe the structure fields, EMPI for employee number, it is 0. They are the initial values. EMPI for employee name is something space, EMPI for employee. Designation is also what? Space. Okay, so employee number is 0, employee name is space, and employee designation is also what? Space. When I say FI, right, so if you see the content, what I got? I got the initial value 0 space and what? Space. Done. Then I'm assigning the new values. So the old values will be overwritten. So when I say FI, oh sorry, I pressed something else. One second. Let me debug once again. I'll say F8. Okay, I'm getting a new debugger screen. Let me switch to the old debugger. Go to navigate to switch to classic debugger. Done. So if you observe the current values, EMPI for employee number is 0, employee name is space, and employee designation also what? Space. So when you say F5, okay, I got the default values at this stage, 0 space and space. Next, again I'll say F5. So when I say F5, 0 is overwritten with 4, space is overwritten with Raju, again designation space is overwritten with manager. So means what? It can accommodate only single record at any point of time. If you want to store multiple records, then going forward we have a concept called as internal tables. Okay, by using internal tables we can store multiple records. So when I say F8 here, I got the result. Okay, so what we understood so far is how to declare the structure and how to access the structure fields. And whenever we create a structure, memory will be allocated for the structure fields. All the fields are stored one after the other. When do we go for structure? Whenever you want to store the interrelated data in the form of record, we'll go for what? Structure. Any questions up to this point? Okay, done. So this is one of the way to declare the structure. There are multiple ways. Now in the same example, what I'll do is, let me show you another syntax for declaring the structure. So for your reference, I'll just give a comment here. Syntax 1, okay, for declaring structure. So already we know how to give comments. If you start the line with star, the entire line is considered a comment. In C language, we say slash slash. Here we start a line with star, it indicates that it is commented, means it will not be executed, it is only for documentation purpose. Now let me show you the syntax 2. In the same example, I'll say syntax 2 for declaring structure. Yeah, so what I'll do is data, this is another way of declaring the structure, data emp2 like emp. Okay, so when do we go for this structure, this syntax? When you want to create a structure based on what? Existing structure. This EMP is already declared. Na? So if you want to create a structure based on existing structure, we'll go for this. Okay, already in the EMP structure, what are the current values in the EMP structure? Something 4, Raju and what? Manager. So based on that structure, I am creating a new structure. I gave the name as what? EMP2. Okay, so what happens? All the fields of EMP will be assigned to what? EMP2. Okay, now I want to check whether the data is also copied or not. What is the data of EMP structure? 4, Raju and manager. So I want to cross check whether they are copied or not. So how can you check it? Only if you display only, we can understand whether the data is copied or not. So what I'll do here, I'll say, right? Again, for your understanding, let me give it as EMP2 structure. Yeah, what is this now? EMP2 hyphen employee number, EMP2 hyphen employee name, EMP2 hyphen employee designation, EMP2 structure. Okay, something like this. Done. Okay, so what this statement will do, whatever the fields are there for EMP structure will be assigned to what? EMP2 structure. So let me save, check it, no errors, done. When I execute, when I say F8, done. So what happened? Oh, sorry, I'll say F8. Can observe now, this is my EMP2 structure. What is the data available here? 0 space and what? Space. So what is the meaning? What is the meaning? The current values of EMP structure is what? 4 Raju and what? Manager. So the data is not copied, only the structure is copied. When it's a structure, only the fields are copied, but not the data. Understood? The current data of EMP structure is 4 Raju and Manager, but the data is not copied. Only the template is copied. I mean, this is only the fields are copied. Okay, I got 0 space and what? Space. Now, what is my requirement? I want to copy the data from EMP structure to EMP2 structure. There are multiple ways of doing this. So, I'll say EMP. So, what I'm doing here, I'm using assignment operator. This is called as what? Assignment operator. So, I'm assigning EMP2 to what? I'm assigning EMP structure to what? EMP2. Let me cross check now whether it is copied or not. So, I need to print it, then only I'll understand. So I'll say, for your understanding, I'll say EMP2 structure after assignment. This is only for your understanding of the output. I'm giving this message, EMP2 structure after assignment. Let me check when I execute. Yeah, sorry, one second, it is going to the, my keyboard is not proper. So see here, what is this here? I got 4 Raju and what? Manager. So one way of assigning the data between two similar structures is what? By using what? Assignment operator. When I say similar structure, the number of fields, the names of the fields, the data type of the fields, everything is what? Same. Anyhow, EMP2 is created based on EMP only. So both will have what? Similar structure. So how do you copy the data from one structure to another structure? By using what? Assignment operator. Now let me clear that. How do you clear the data? We have a statement called as clear. I'll say clear EMP2. So whatever the data is there in the EMP2 structure will be cleared. Will be cleared. So let me check whether it is cleared or not. So again, I'll give a message, EMP2 structure after what? Clear. Save it, check, activate. Right. So when I execute, when I say effect, I'll say F8. Done. So what happened here? See, I got what? 0 space and space. Means the data got what? Cleared. Whatever the data is in EMP2, it got cleared. Now once again, I want to copy the data from EMP2 what? EMP2. Okay, earlier we have used what? Assignment operator. Now I'll say, I'll use a statement called as move EMP2 EMP2. Okay, let me check whether it's copied or not. Let me reprint it. EMP2 structure after move. Okay, so let me save it. Check for the syntax. Activate this. Okay, so when I'm having the issue with my system, so don't worry about this debugging. I'll say F8. Yeah, when I say F8, yeah, is it copied now? EMP2 structure after what? Move. What is that I got? 4 Raju and what? Manager. Understood. Earlier I used assignment operator. Now I used what? Move statement. Once again, let me clear the data. Again, I'll copy this. Okay. Again, I'm clearing the data. I'm cross-checking whether it is cleared or not. When I say F8. Yes, I got what? 0. Space and what? Space. It got cleared. Now once again I want to copy the data between these two structures. So I'll say, earlier I used assignment operator, then I use move statement. Now I'll say move corresponding. Move corresponding. So I'll just give a message after what? Move corresponding. Okay, let me save it. Check for the syntax, activateness. Understood? I'm using move corresponding. Let's see whether it's copied or not. So I'll say fit. Done. What happened here? I got what? 4, Raju, and what? Manager. Understood? So what I'm trying to show is between two similar structures, I can copy the data in three different ways. What are they? Assignment operator, move statement, move corresponding. What exactly is the difference, you will understand in the coming examples. Okay, so what we understood from this example is two syntaxes for declaring the structure. Syntax one is the basic structure where we are creating the structure with the required fields, and we understood that structure fields got initialized to default values, and to access the structure fields you have to use structure name followed by hyphen. Okay, and we are creating one more structure based on what? Existing structure. What this syntax will do, it will only copy the structure, it will only copy the fields, it doesn't copy the data. To copy the data between two similar structures, I can use assignment operator, move statement, or what? Move corresponding. And to clear the data from the structure, we are able to use a clear statement. Any questions in this part so far? Okay, right. So feel free to ask others. Okay, done. So now let us try to understand the difference between what this assignment move and what move corresponding. Okay, now what I'll do is, so in my program we have two structures now. What are they? EMP structure and what? EMP two structure. Okay, so now
I have one simple question here.
Yeah, yeah.
Normally when you use the structure, we use the coding standard called work area.
Correct.
So here, I mean, is it not mandatory, but most of the time I've seen the program.
Correct, correct.
They use
correct.
Work.
Correct. Yeah, yeah. We'll see, we'll see. Correct. What you said is absolutely right. Just like for parameters, we start with P underscore. Variables, we are starting with V underscore. Okay, work areas also, again, project to project, we may follow different coding standards. In some projects, we may start with LS, or in some projects, GS, or in some projects, WA. WA indicates what? Work area. Okay, here also, I'll try to follow the standards going forward. Right? Okay. Right. Now, so we have two structures now, EMP structure and what? EMP 2. Now, let me create one more structure. Data, what I'll do is I'll say begin of EMP3. Okay, data begin of EMP3. Let me declare some fields here. Okay, I'll say employee number, or no, not EMP3. Let me say data begin of. Okay, generally you can start with WA or LS kind of thing, but since I want to focus on the concept here, I'm not following the standard in this example. But always you have to follow. Okay. In the next example, I'll follow that. So I'll say begin of department. Okay. I'll take some fields here. Department number type I. Okay. And what is this? Department name of something. 20 type C. Okay. 1 second. Yeah, I'll give the name as Rajesh Kumar. What is the employee name with here? Employee name of 15 type C. So I give the name as what? Rajesh Kumar. Done. Yeah, here I'll give this as department name of 10 type C. I'll close the structure. End of what? Department. So I created a structure with how many fields? 2 fields. Let me check the data in this structure. Okay, I'll just print that department structure. I'll say write. Department hyphen, what is the field names? Department number, and then what? Department hyphen, department name. So what is the expected result for this? Department number is integer, so by default you'll have zeros. Department name is character. By default, you'll have what? Space. So when I execute this, when I say F8, when I say F8 here, you can see I got 0, what? Space. Employee number is 0, and department number is 0, and department name is what? Space. Now what I'll do, I want to copy the data from EMP structure to department structure. Both are dissimilar structures. In the sense, EMP structure has got 3 fields and department structure has got what? 2 fields. And even the field names are what? Different. The field names are also different. But let me check whether I can copy or not. So I'll say now, I'll say what? I'm assigning EMP to what? Department. I'm assigning the EMP to department. So let me check it now. Okay, department structure after assigning what? EMP. Something. Okay, some meaningful name. I'm reprinting. Okay, what is the data in the EMP structure? 4 Rajesh Kumar and something manager. Okay, so let me check whether it is copied or not. Activate this. Okay, so when I execute, you can observe now what I got. Department number is what? 4. Department name I got what? Rajesh Kumar. So here the focus is, even though the field names are different, it is copying. Even though the field names are different, it is copying. Means employee number is copied to department number and employee name is copied to a department name. What is the employee name width I gave? 15. What is the department name width I gave? 10. So I got only the first 10 characters. I got only, actual name is what? Rajesh Kumar. But I got only the first 10 characters. Why? Because the maximum width of the department name is what? Character of 10. That's the reason I got only up to 10 characters. Am I clear? So the point you have to focus here is, I am able to use assignment operator. On what basis it is working means, this assignment operator will not check for number of fields, it will not check for field names. I repeat, assignment operator will not check for number of fields and the field names. It checks whether the corresponding data types are same. When I say corresponding data types, what is the data type of the first field here? In the EMP structure, first field data type is what? Integer. In the department also, first field data type is what? Integer. Same. In the second, in the EMP structure, what is the second field data type? Character. Okay. In the second structure, second field is also what? Character. Since the corresponding data types are same, I am able to use what? Assignment operator. It is not bother about the width also. There in the source, it is character of 15. In the target, it is character of 10. But still it is working. I got only up to what? 10 characters, but it's not giving me any error. So when I can use assignment operator, when the corresponding data types are same, I can use what? Assignment operator. Let me clear the data. I'll say clear department. Department structure after what? Clear. Okay, so save it, check for the syntax, activate, done. Okay, I've activated. Now when I execute this, what I got here? 0 space, means it got cleared. Now what I want to check, whether I can use move statement or not. Move is also similar to what? Assignment. In the sense, I'm able to use assignment means I should able to use move also. So I'll say move EMP to department. Let me cross check here. Departments. If you display only, you will understand whether it is copied or not. That's the reason every time I'm displaying. Okay. So if you see here. Yes, what happened? It got copied. Understood? Department same as what assignment only. Na? Here also I got 4 and what? Rajesh Kumar. So when I can use the move statement, same story. What is that? If the corresponding data types are same, I can use what? Move statement. I can use a move statement. Now what I'll do, let me try to clear first. Okay, so it would be cleared. When I say F8, yeah, if you observe this at the end, yes, it got what? Cleared. I got 0 and what? Space. Done. Let me try to use move corresponding now. Okay, I'll use move corresponding ENP to department. Here also let me say move corresponding. Okay, so let me save it, check for the syntax, activate this. Done. One second. Yeah, so when I execute now, let's see whether move corresponding is copying the data or not. No, understood. Department structure after move corresponding is what? Still what? 0 and what? Space. So what is the concept of move corresponding? Move corresponding will try to copy the data between the fields which have the same name. Understood? So between EMP and department, there is no field which is having the same name now. That's why none of the data is what? Copied. Understood? Move corresponding will try to copy the data between two fields with the same name. With the same name, but irrespective of the sequence. Okay, wherever the position of those fields, it will copy if the field names are what? Same. But since there is no matching field name, okay, it is not copying the data. So to summarize, what you have to understand is we can use assignment and move statement. I can say both assignment and move are what? Same. We can use assignment and move statement when the corresponding data types are what? Same. Okay. Whereas move corresponding will try to copy the data between two matching field names. Done. So any question so far in this part? Right. We have many scenarios. We'll discuss one by one. So this is one scenario. Now, in the same program, I'll do it. Let me declare one more structure. Just try to focus. Begin of department 2, I'll say. Wantedly, I'm saying begin of department 2. Let me give the field name as something, employee name. Okay, or I'll say not employee name, one second. Yeah, I'll say location, try to understand. Location of 15, type what? C. Then I'll take another field, location of 15, type C. Then I'll say employee number type I. Then I'll take another field, like what? Department name of something. Or let me say department number type I, end of what? Department 2. So wantedly I took some fields here like location, employee number and what? Department number. Let me try to print the data. As of now it will contain what? Default values, zeros and what? Spaces. So department 2 structure, I'll try to print it, right? What is this? Department 2 hyphen what? Location. Department 2 hyphen employee number, department 2 hyphen what? Department number. Okay, so let me save it, check for the syntax. Done. Execute this. When I say F8, yeah, if you observe the result at the end here, yeah, what is the data? This is location, character, I got space. This is employee number 0, it is integer. And again, department number is also what? Integer. I got 0. Done. Now I'll say like this. I'll say department 2, something like this. What I'm doing, I'm assigning EMP to what? Department. I'm trying to assign EMP to department. When I can use assignment operator, when the corresponding data types are what? Same. What is the first field in the EMP structure? Employee number. What is the data type of that employee number field? Integer. Integer. What is the first field in the department two structure? It is character. Understood? So the corresponding data type is not matching. Now. There it is. What is the sequence of data types? ICC. The sequence of data type is what? ICC. Here the sequence of data type is what? CII. So the corresponding data types are not same. So I'm expecting a syntax error here. When I do syntax check, good. I got a syntax error. What is that? Department 2 and EMP cannot be converted to each other. Okay? Cannot be converted to what? Each other. Am I clear? So I'm getting an error because assignment operator I can use only when the corresponding data types are what? Same. So this is giving me what? Syntax error. Let me check whether I can use move statement. I should not able to use move also because both assignment and depart and move is what? Same. So I'll say move what? EMP to what? Department number. Here also move also will check for what? Corresponding data types. Since the corresponding data types are not same, I should get a similar error here. Syntax error. What is that? Department 2 and EMP cannot be converted to each other. So it is giving me what? Syntax error. Done. It is giving me a syntax error. Okay. Now I'll try to use move corresponding. I'll try to use move corresponding EMP to department number. What is the concept of move corresponding? It doesn't bother about the corresponding data types. It doesn't bother about the number of fields. It doesn't bother about the sequence of fields. It checks whether any matching field names are there. I repeat, it only checks whether any matching field names are there. Okay, so if you take this EMP, what are the field names here? Employee number, employee name, and employee designation. Here it is what? In the department 2, what are the field names? Location, employee number, and department. So out of three fields, one field is matching. What is that field is matching? Employee number. Okay, there also we have employee number, but the position of employee number is what? First position. Here the position of employee number is what? Second position. So it is not bother about the position. Okay, and as of now I am not focusing on the data type. Here it is integer. Here also it is what? Here also it is what? Integer. But later on in another scenario I'll change the data type. Okay, as of now just remember there is one matching field name, but the position of that field is what? Different. Let me check whether it is copied or not. Okay, department 2 structure. After what? Move corresponding. Okay, let me print it. No errors. No errors. Means I am able to use what? Move corresponding. So when I execute, when I say F8, see at the end what happened here. Location is space. What is this? Employee number is 4. This is department number. So what is the employee number in the EMP structure? 4. The position of that employee number in the EMP structure is first position. Here it is in the second position, but still it has copied the data. So what we have to understand about the move corresponding so far, it only checks for the matching field names. It does not bother about the number of fields, the sequence of fields, and the data type of the fields also. It does not bother about the data types of the fields also. Hope it's clear to everyone. Any questions? But it is recommended not to use move corresponding statement frequently. It is recommended not to use move corresponding statement frequently because it will degrade the performance. How it will degrade the performance? It will check for the matching field names. Na? So how it will check internally? See, we are saying move corresponding EMP to department 2. One second, please. Okay. So how it will degrade the performance? It will check for the matching field names. No? So how it will check internally? We are saying move corresponding EMP to department 2. So it will take the first field here. What is this employee number? This employee number will be compared with all the fields of the target structure. It will check with this, not matching. It will check with this. Yes, it is matching. So it will copy the data. It will check with this. It is not matching. Again, it will take the second field. Okay, it will check with all the fields of a target structure. Means internally what happens, each field of the source structure will be compared with what? All the fields of a target structure. This comparison is a time consuming process. This comparison is a time consuming process. So that's why it will degrade the performance. Understood? So we are getting the result, but it will degrade the performance slightly because unnecessarily it will compare each field of source structure with all the fields of a target structure, which will degrade the performance. There is another issue with move corresponding. It may lead to runtime error. It may lead to runtime error. Let me quickly cover that point here. So what I'll do is just 5 minutes. So here I'll create another structure, data begin of what? Department 3, employee number type I, and here I'll take this as wantedly. I'll take department name type I. Wantedly, I'm taking, actually department name cannot be character integer, but wantedly I'm taking what? Integer. Done. Now let me quickly print it. Department 3 structure, department 3 structure. Let me print all the fields. Department 3 hyphen what? Location. What else? Department 3 hyphen employee number. Department 3 hyphen what? Department name. Okay. I'll not give department name. Let me give it as employee name. I'll give it as employee name. This also is what? Employee name. Done. So as of now, you'll get, what is the error I got? End of department 3, sorry. This is end of department 3. So let me save it, check for the syntax, activate, done. When I execute, when I execute this, observe this. What I got? Space 0 and 0, done. Now, I cannot use assignment operator because assignment requires what? Corresponding data type should be what? Same. Here it is ICC, here it is what? CII, so I cannot use it. Similarly, I cannot use what? Move also. Now I'll try to use what? Move corresponding. So I'll say move corresponding. What is this? EMP to department 3. So what this move corresponding will try to do? It will try to, move corresponding will try to what? Check for the matching field names. So if you see here, if you observe this, what are the two matching field names? Employee number is there, employee name is there. Here also we have what? Employee number and employee name. The positions are different, but the field names are what? Same. This employee number is also integer, no problem. But here, if you observe employee name, it is character of what? 15. What is the value available? Rajesh Kumar. Since move corresponding will check only for what? Field names. It will not check for the data type. So since the field name is matching here, it will try to copy that character value to this particular integer field. But integers cannot store what? Decimal values. No? So when I do syntax check, no errors, done. Let me activate. When I execute, I don't have any syntax error. Okay. But when I execute this, okay, when I execute, when I say F8, good. I got what? Runtime error. Understood? During the program execution, I got the runtime error. What is the error I got? Rajesh Kumar cannot be interpreted as a number. Okay. An exception has occurred, which is explained in more detail below. Runtime error means during the program execution, if you get any error, we call it as what? Runtime error. Okay. So an attempt was made to interpret the value Rajesh Kumar as a number because it has tried to copy this character value to a numeric field, which is invalid. So see where is the error location? If you scroll down, Yeah, you can see. See this arrow pointer. I got there in the 104 line. So what is happening? Move corresponding may sometime lead to what? Runtime error, not every time was. Okay. In what cases it will lead to runtime error? When the data types are not compatible, when you're trying to copy character value to integers, they are not compatible. No? So it may lead to what? Runtime error. So because of these two issues, it is recommended to minimize the usage of what? Move corresponding. What is the limitation of move corresponding? It will degrade the performance. How it will degrade? Each field of the source structure will be compared with what? All the fields of what? Target structure. And another point is what? Sometimes it may lead to what? Runtime error. In what cases? When the move corresponding will check for what? Matching field names without the data type. Okay. So if the data types are not compatible, it will lead to what? Runtime error. So am I clear? It is trying to copy in EMP structure, employee name is character. In department 3 structure, employee name is integer. Integers cannot hold what? Characters. Reverse is possible. I can store integers in characters, but I cannot store characters in what? Integer. So it will give what? Runtime error. So when I execute this, see once again, when I execute and I say F8, I got the runtime error. Rajesh Kumar cannot be interpreted as a number. So we should very carefully use what? Move corresponding. Okay, any questions, please ask me. So I'll just comment it for your reference, otherwise you'll get the runtime error. So I'll just give a comment here. What is this? Leads to, out of your comments in between, you have to use double quotes. Leads to runtime error. Whatever you give after double quotes, it is nothing but what? Comment. So when you're practicing in your systems, you uncomment this and practice so that you'll get the runtime error. You'll understand why we got the runtime error. So any questions, please ask me. Latika, Nilima, Shrikant, Vamshi, Sayed, Chinna, Manika, Shivani, Partha. Alright, okay. Done. So tomorrow we'll see other ways of declaring the structures. Other ways of declaring the structures. This structures is very important. Almost in every requirement, we'll be using this structures and internal tables concepts going forward. Okay. Done. So I'll wind off for today. We'll continue tomorrow. Shalom. Any issues, concerns here, please drop me a mail. I'll reply. Okay.